So first of all, I want to thank the organizers of this conference for the invitation, and I would like to talk about Pavel Čech, the Czech artist and author, and I would like to speak about few picture and I will talk about the book Dědečkové, the granddads. Pavel Čech is an illustrator, and he also paints. He's doing many artistic work. Tomáš Prokupek, the critic, says, and I will paraphrase. So the Pavel Čech Čech became a visible personality of Czech literature, and he became a locksmith. And always he is doing what he believes in, and not what the authorities dictated him. And he is creating illustrations for children. He became he was only Pavel Čech was a locksmith, then he worked in a factory, and later on he also was fireman. And he said, okay, when there was no fire, he could paint. He had inspiration in various Slovak illustrators, as Dušan Kalaj, Albin Brunovský, or Kulhánek. He learned to print graphic patiently according to the books on a handmade press and gained each experience by his own experimentation. And he created his own style. Since 2004, he has been a freelancer, exclusively devoted to literary and illustration work painting. After 1989, he entered the market with an album. It was not commercial success, and later on he didn't continue with this work. The breakthrough came with the book that he created for friends' public house, the garden. You may see in the picture the garden from 1962, and you may see that there are really similarities, the motifs. The garden of Pavel Čech continues and develops this Jiří Trnka garden. From Havličko Brod, there was an artist who saw this book in France, in a bookstore, and he contacted with Pavel Čech as he saw that it is Czech writer. And he started connecting with him and started publishing his books. So Pavel Čech really published dozens of books, and we may divide them into few groups. The first group is, let's say, chamber albums. They are aimed at fantasy, so based on children dreaming. Later, the second group is the fairy tale plot Sige, for example, The Adventure of the Spider Chandra was translated into Slovak language. So it was one of his key starting. And the third group is based on adventure. It has kind of initiation importance feature. So it is developing some kind of being adult, more adult for older children. And the fourth, final group cover comic stories, which are based on many pictures. And this is really kind of difficult to say what is the limit for age. It is both for children and adults. We may, this is a book, allegory, based without words, and it is only A. It is about totalitarian regime. The world of Pavel Čech is very interesting. Pavel Čech is one of authors that really became known for his own world. He produced archetypes, and very interesting is that some characters and environment is going from one book to another, or for example, we see some kind of authors like Balzac. Pavel Čech is aimed at visually made concept. So he connects textual and pictorial concept. Sometimes he is making collage, and there is a concept book inside of a book, or allusions from his famous and inspiring authors. You may see in the picture the concept of garden. Garden is connected with exotism and adventure. You may see that in the picture that there are trees, and maybe the trees behind the trees, and in the trees there are some creatures and exotic animals. On the symbolic level, garden is a garden that is a symbolic topic. Sometimes there is a concept of the tree of life and tree of goodness and evil. Another concept is city. City is depicted as a labyrinth that is hiding secrets, stairs leading to somewhere, the locked gates in secret hidden places. It is very interesting that the city environment as an adventure, Jaroslav Foglar took up this concept, and he was one of Pavel Čech author that he admired. Another concept that Pavel Čech uses is the concept of an island. Island as adventure. In Czech Republic we do not have any islands, so for us island is an exotic topic. It is connected with adventure. An island is also a kind of symbol where we want to go and where are our inner dreams represented. Other concept that he uses is water. Water in a swimming pool, water in the sea. Many characters of his works are afraid of water. Many times these characters are drawing in the water. And many times after this drawing there comes some kind of a resurrection. It is connected with adventures, and in Czech's illustrations there is a complex of inner state environment. The Radko Malek wrote a book, A Small Little Sea, and Pavel Čech made illustrations for this. Another concept that Pavel Čech uses is the concept of Indians. Aristoton Sidna, the book Dva divoši, Two Indians, he was inspired by this book. And after 1989, Pavel Čech became a member of an Indian group, and he is exploring this semantic in a deeper. Indian is a concept for him that represents wise person, strong, spiritually filled, and of course Karol May was inspiration for Pavel Čech. Inspiration. Another concept that in Pavel Čech works are details and small objects that are not visible maybe, or they are just small things, for example knife or watch or bicycle. Watch may represent child's desire for eternity. All this is in Czech's value system. Although his heroes leave the clear, safe children's world, they retain the ability to dream, feelings and loyalty to child ideals. The values stand for the keeping up the promise between friends, then a sense of justice, and personal courage to face evil. What shocked me, the characters are either children or old people, no adults in middle age. And there is a book that the old men are really enjoying all types of life because they know that eternity is before them. And we may see in this book the old granddads. We see that these characters are various. For example, one of them is a visionary who wants to create some kind of a watch and eternity, stop time, and other concepts. You may see in the picture, this is the book, Dědečkové, the old granddads. They are composed, this book is composed of various episodes without text, comments. These are comics, but without traditional comic bubbles. Only the text is communicated through pictures. So the space-time is limited. We can reconstruct it later on. For Pavel Čech, literature is important double point. The first is superficial, we may say, and the child may understand it. The second point, the second climax, is hidden, symbolic, and not obvious, many times not obvious for adults. However, many times the second point is revealed in the final last picture, and therefore we are to read it again and again. The second point supports the goal of the book, and I would like to share with you one example. I made an experiment. I'm teaching future teachers, for example, future pedagogues, and I worked with 90 students, and I showed them one episode that is named Button. And so I will show you pictures in the order that it is in the book. And please look at in the pictures, look at them, and try to interpret them. Then I asked my students, I asked them to, for example, describe in one word, in two words. And the students took notes so that they were really not influenced by each other. So please look at the pictures. And other pages. So I would like to share with the results that my students said. The majority felt it just on general level. They didn't felt some necessity to name the character. It is an old man, so we may see that he has some kind of past behind him. So only 6 students named his protagonist based on that he has the buttons. He said that he was maybe Taylor. Some people named him, some students named him in their answers. For example, Horáček or Ludvík Hala. Or some of them gave him a familiar first name like Jan, Antonio. In other cases, the shabby appearance and loneliness of the figure translated into names with negative connotations. For example, Hafish or Morose. Only 10 students tried to concretize the motivation of the act or the past of the protagonist. For example, returning home from church, marketplace, Christmas market. So they said that maybe he's widower. You may see that there is a picture, wedding picture. Maybe his late wife was, for example, Alice. She got her coat. She was making coats and she taught him to sew. Some students said that he takes good care of his coat so he would not disgrace himself when he goes to see his grandchildren. Some students said that at the end the man just blows the fire at the end and goes to bed. Other students had problem with missing of vocabulary because some of the interpretation remained on the primitive level as they brought only a descriptive record of the story. Many faced a lack of vocabulary as they considered the kerosene lamp to be a burner. Or there was lack of vocabulary. Some, they let the figure sew the button or embroider the button instead of stitching the button. Also, there was one mistaken evaluation of visual stimuli. One of the students considered the house to be a castle as a historizing style. Regarding the perspective from which the story is told, most of them all held the position of an omniscient narrator, only one of the students retold the story from the perspective of the button itself. The students described the story as a sad, balanced senior age, loneliness, loss, relationship to all things, that the story is about life experience, self-sufficiency, patience, diligence, satisfaction from well-done work. Only 8 responses captured the woman's portrait on the wall and deduced the old man's loneliness from the fact of his widowhood. So there was kind of consensual conclusion. The last picture of the story, I didn't show the last picture. There will be the second point. In the moment when I showed them the last picture, the students really experienced really shock, really deep emotions, because all these thoughts up till this time, they had new ideas, new concepts, there were more details, so to endure, not to be broke down. So this maybe seemingly not important action to stitch one button became very, very key and important, because when he will take this is in a more deeper meaning. For me, I saw many symbols and information when I communicated with these pictures. I, as a teacher, Svatava Urbanova, my teacher, taught about this. It is said that picture books are only for people who do not want to read a lot of text. The narrative picture of Pavel Čech is not of this kind. They are read slowly and they need repeated reading. We gain the whole thought and deeper meaning after rereading it second time, and then when reading it third time, we dig out the most deepest thoughts. The end of the citation. So we saw, based on my experiment, yes, the story is about stitching one's button, but the protagonist is very special. So the story that we are describing without his name is very significant for him. And the hero has more significant meaning for them. So the recipients see the details. They are taught to see the details. Maybe when you look in the second picture, there are truck cars. Later on, when they look again through the pictures, then they saw the wall picture of the wedding of the man and his wife. The last picture has the only detail that has color. It is the Jewish yellow star on the coat on the last picture. So therefore, you reread it and it is really like this. There is one yellow part of it in the beginning, but you cannot see it well because you just don't see the details in the beginning. It was maybe very important to publish these pictures in a way that the last picture would be alone, the last order. For me, it was very interesting that through this visual interpretation, some students commented on sounds. For example, the creepy sound of a stairs or of a chair where the man was sitting, or the smell of the candle, the light. Some students described also the sensation of warm or coldness, for example, the cold atmosphere in his room. The students are now at the university, and it was for me very interesting that these students now studying at the university, they had to be led to be able to interpret it. So this generation, I observed, was taught kind of well on seeing details, but this they are not able to see deeper meaning in it. What does it mean for us? It means for us, the parents, the teachers, that the students nowadays, the generation, we need to be a leader in show them how to connect with deeper meaning, with details, and to teach them how they can find deeper meaning in this. So finally, I would like to read at the end one of the interpretation. It is an interpretation concerned only on the part without the last picture, okay? So this is this. Oh, I fell. Where? What happened? I am lying on the ground, but this is not the place where I should be. I am supposed to be in the line, second from above. Beautiful, I'm red, second from above. So why am I lying on the ground? Where are the threads that kept me on my coat? And where is the coat? And where is the gentleman whose coat belongs to? Perhaps he didn't leave me. Probably he is going home now. He walks through the passage, enters his apartment and hangs his coat on a hanger. And he certainly noticed that I miss him, and he will look for me. He wouldn't have come to another button and replace me. I'm second from above. Or that he would turn on the lamp in order to replace me? Would he really do that? What if he chooses another? And another color. He wouldn't forget me. I'm second from above. I have been lying here for a long time. I guess it happened. I guess he doesn't miss me. He chose another, probably nicer button, and stitched it in my place. I am probably not the second from the top. I'm no one anymore. Surely the man had already stitched a new button in my place and forgot about me. He blew out the lamp as a memory of me. The flame went out. Seemingly, ordinary and small things can be replaced quite easily. But everything belongs somewhere. Thank you for your attention.